Meanwhile, the Creek Fire continues to rage in California tonight, cresting 160,000 acres burned. But one News Channel 5 employee was there on the mountain when the fire started and feels lucky he got out safely. News Channel 5's Kyle Horan takes us inside. What happened?
I mean, usually the lake is full of water.
These moments are captured by News Channel 5's chief photographer, Mike Rose. Rose is an avid hiker, taking several trips per year, but this one was the big one for 2020.
Myself and two family members had applied for permits to go hike the John Muir Trail. It's a world famous trail. It's hard to get permits for it.
It's 230 miles. He's been training since March. But the trip was cut short after the eighth day when Rose and his two cousins saw this in the sky.
It's insane, the size of the cloud.
It's called a pyrocumulonimbus cloud, a formation caused by the fire. At the time, Rose didn't know what he was looking at. The mystery was cleared up when further down the trail, in the Vermilion Valley, they came across a remote resort and answers to a lot of questions. The Creek Fire was spreading throughout the mountainside, just 10 to 15 miles away. Rose and his companions stayed the night, but the next day,
all the smoke had settled down in, and the visibility when we woke up was like a quarter of a mile. It smelled like hell. It was just awful.
Red and brown thick smoke covered everything. The three men decided to get out of there and encountered a fisherman at a nearby dam, a man named Glenn Roberts, who worked in search and rescue before retiring. He agreed to take the three to Fresno. The road out was treacherous and fire was visible, though Rose says he was never in danger. Still, he doesn't know how someone could have let this happen.
There were no fires allowed. And then when you hear somebody shooting off fireworks for a gender reveal party, you just kind of scratch your head going, why would you do that? You know, just pop a balloon or something, you know, don't shoot off fireworks.
Kyle Horan, News Channel 5.
We're so glad he's okay. We'll take you inside the ongoing efforts to fight these fires ahead at 6:30.